More and more organizations are using collaboration software because it allows their end users to work wherever they happen to be. One of the daunting tasks with that, however, is keeping track of who's a member of a group, who's an owner of a group, what threads are set up, what channels are being built, and that can really just be a logistics nightmare. But one of the things that Access Rights Manager does really, really well is connect directly to Microsoft Teams and let you manage it there. Let me show you how that works. Since today we're going to specifically talk about Teams, we'll start with resources. And then select our Teams connectors. And here's our team. So Access Rights Manager will actually pull out the owner and member information for any team within Teams. For example, the All Colleagues has a whole bunch of members. But maybe I just need to see the owners. For me, the easiest way to do that is just flip this up here, and then I see everything grouped by the permission level. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 owners. Now suppose we need to make a change to this, like maybe we need to promote one of the members to owner. You can do that by right-clicking on the team, modifying the access rights, and then just drag and drop. You see that Fox will be removed from the members list and put into the owners list. And then apply. And just like every permission change in Access Rights Manager, we want to have a full audit trail. We can execute that right now, in the background, during the overnight, scheduled, or we can save it for scheduling at another time. But we're just going to go ahead and run it immediately. In addition to modifying permissions within a team, you can also create teams and create channels within teams. Just right-click, select Create a Team, or if you select a specific team, you can create a channel. There's a couple of things I really, really like about managing teams from within Access Rights Manager. First and foremost, everything's in the same interface. So the same place I manage my Active Directory and my Exchange organization, I'm managing my Teams infrastructure. In addition to that, every time one of these changes needs to be made, I get a chance to put in an audit log. And that lets me know and all of the admins know exactly what was happening at that time.